PowerDirector 16 tutorial. How can I make my video walk backwards, walk forward, walk backwards, walk forward, and just create a whole new effect like the walking elk? In this tutorial of PowerDirector 16, I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm actually going to show you how to speed it up twice, walk a backward, walk a forward, and you can actually tighten this up by making your video clips shorter. So we're going to take our video clip, we're going to drag it down to our timeline, and I've got myself a big video here is what I've got. I'm not going to need any sound, so I'm going to remove that. And this is what I'm left with. So I have a video here of where I actually ended up recording an entire elk walking across the field. He's a pretty guy. It's springtime. He's lost his antlers. He doesn't have his antlers anymore. But I look for the spot to where the actual elk is walking across the screen here in PowerDirector 16. When I find the point or the video I want to use, I'm going to pay attention here. Now notice I've got some walking here. That looks pretty cool. I like that part there. So I'm kind of going to back it up to where that little guy starts walking again. And I guess I'll go right about there. I'm going to cut this section out, and I don't need the rest of this whatsoever. So I'm just going to hit the delete key, remove and fill, and pull it back. Now, what section do I want is the section I'm going to cut out here. So I've got him walking. You know, I could just do it right there, for example, or even go a little bit further. And there we go there. And then I can cut this here. So now I've got the segment of video that I want to mess with. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this, okay? And I'm going to put this at the end of my timeline. You see where that red line is? And then I'm going to hit Control V, as in Control V for Victor. And that's going to give me a complete copy of the first one. I could also right-click on the timeline here and just paste it there, as you can see. But make sure the scrubber, this red line here, is at the end of the video, or even, you know, even pull this a little bit ahead of the video to make sure it's at the end. Right click and give me a paste. Now I've got another one there. Again, I'm going to make sure I pull this down and give me another paste. So this way I've got multiple copies of the original of what I was doing, and we're doing this in PowerDirector 16. Now, the very first one, I want to speed it up. Now if you try to, let's go to Tools, Power Tools first. If you try to reverse this and then speed it up, you're going to get a message saying this is turned off and turned on, and it's just going to confuse you. So do all your speeding up first. So again, we're going to click that video. We're going to work on this first one, Tools, Power Tools. And then we're going to do video speed. Now another thing I could do, and I'm going to get out of that for a second, show you this. I could hold my control key down and I could literally speed them all up at the same time. And then go to Tools and Power Tools. And I could speed them both up as what I want. So I'm going to speed up these two here, for example. Control key down, click. So now I got both videos selected. Go to my Tools, Power Tools. I'll notice video speed. Now I can speed up both of these videos right away. Right here we got a 1. I'll put a 2 there. And I'll say that's good to go. And you'll notice it has an exclamation mark under both videos. So now they're super fast. I'm going to spread this out a little bit. I'm going to click the first video, and now I'm going to go back to Tools and Power Tools. And this is where I'm going to do a video reverse. That's it. This one, I'm not going to do a reverse. Okay? So pull this back to the beginning, and you'll notice what happens is my little guy's walking in reverse. And then it kicks in the next clip, and now he's walking forward. That's pretty much the gist of how you actually do it right there. So again, set your speed of your video first, and then set your reverser forward in tools, power tools. So I wanted this section here now, and I actually don't need that other one. So I just made a video of way too many, is what I did. Okay, so I got this one here. Now, I want to do a short walk, a fast walk, a short walk, a fast walk. So I'm kind of looking for the spot where he's kind of got a little trot going. Run to kind of right there. That's kind of nice. So I'm going to cut that out. I'm just clicking here, hitting my delete key to cut that section out. Pulling it back. And then I'm going to determine what I want and how many frames I want. So I could go right about there, for example, and say, okay, that's all I want. And then I'm going to cut that and remove the back. So now all I've got is this little section here. So we're going to do the same thing as we did with these two long ones, except we made it a lot shorter. So I'm going to simply click on this, and I'm going to, you know, right-click and copy it, or Control-C, as you'll see right there. So I copy that. Make sure this red line's at the end. And I'm going to do a paste or a control V as in Victor. Again, I need a bunch of them. And you can't just go control V, control V, control V. You literally have to make sure that the red line is at the end. If you see the overwrite come up, you haven't gone far enough with the red line. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm right about there at the red line. You see it says overwrite. Just click off to the side. Make sure that scrubber comes all the way to the end. And then put your control V for Victor in there. And we kind of want an even amount. So what I got 2, 4, 6, 7. I want an even amount. So, you know, 6, 8, 10, that type of thing. Now they're all going to be the same speed. So in this situation, I'm going to hold my shift key down and click the end. So originally, I clicked the first one all the way to the end here, hold my shift key down, and click. Now I've got them all selected. Okay. Now I'm actually going to go to Tools and Power Tools, and I'm going to set my video speed first. And again, I'm just going to do it to a 2 over here. And now all my videos are set to, click the X, and they all have the exclamation mark, so I know they're all done. So I've already got the speed set, so now if I fly through it, it's basically the same video over and over and over and over, but super fast speed. So what do we want? We want the first guy maybe walking forward. The second video, again, we'll go to Tools, Power Tools. We'll make him walk in reverse. This one will let go forward. The next one will let go in reverse. This one will let go forward. This one will go in reverse. Again, this one forward. This one in reverse. So now, we'll see what look we've got as it goes along. And boom, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Throw some music to that. We've got something pretty cool. So back to the beginning, always set the speed first, then set whether you want it to go forward or backwards under Tools. And you'll see he's trotting along. Now we got him going forward. And you probably use this on short clips like I'm showing you there really quick back and forth to create something a little funny, a little bit of an effect. But that's kind of cool how you can do a forward reverse within PowerDirector 16. Add some animation in the way of speed. And if anything, you know, pick up some music, toss it in the bottom, and now you got something kind of cool. If you're using PowerDirector 16, make sure you hit subscribe, hit share, hit that like button. Help me out, guys. Go share it on Facebook, help your friends, and let everybody know how to use PowerDirector 16 like a professional. It's not hard. It's just a matter of some practice. At any rate, guys, I'll catch you on the next one.